As every human being learns, the cycle of desire is eternal. Chinky 30. With the shadow of desire and the city of rapture, it's the path of lightness. My wisdom story. I was said to have shot out my mother's womb like a rocket and then nursed like a baby whale. As soon as I could talk, I made people laugh, and as soon as I could walk, I ran everywhere I wasn't supposed to go. I was on a mission to experience every single part of life. So I gobbled it up throughout my teens and found myself becoming a young actor. I wanted to experience the sound of applause. I loved being able to be anyone and try anything my mind could dream up. Soon I desired the experience of being rich and famous, and so I tried that for a long time. I threw my money around like gum wrappers and chewed up my fans like chips. But those flippant times only made me feel empty and alone. My sensitive soul hungered for something different and deeper. I wanted to use every single one of my gifts so that I could have an even better impact. Soon I was popular all over the world. But no matter how huge or demanding my achievements were, I still wanted more. For a while, I thought I'd be happy if I could just learn to completely trust my instincts. When I mastered that, all I wanted was for my performance to lift the spirit of all humanity. Until the fire in me all but burned out, I became depressed and over-serious. My only desire was to end desire. That's when I discovered Buddhism and meditated for hours in order to become one with everything and finally transcend my never-ending ache. But soon I realized even that was a desire. No matter what I did, the desire would not go away. Things started to change. I started to lighten up, but not in an ungrounded way. I generally stopped trying to control my life. I surrendered totally to all of it, even the most painful parts, including my utter helplessness in relation to my own desires and the inevitable disappointments that followed. I was finally free. My gift to you. I bring good and bad news. The bad: you are not in control of your destiny, and you are never going to get rid of your desire. The good: accepting this bad news will free you to trust in life. It is time to fully feel your desires and to realize that feeling them doesn't mean acting on them indiscriminately or repressing them. You can welcome a desire into your home without allowing it to control your life. Being human is quite a trip, and life is quite a game. A comedy and tragedy all at once. You might as well enjoy the ride. Keep a sense of humor. Do not pretend to live lightly. Embrace and emanate a true lightness of being. With such an attitude, you won't need to fear your feelings, no matter how painful. A lightness will burn so bright in you, it'll beam out of your eyes, no matter what is happening. If you have this jinky in your profile, or you just feel it because it's activated by the sun, you can ask the following questions to deepen your contemplation. Where are you taking life too seriously? Is your strict adherence to certain principles preventing you from exploring your true passions? Is it possible that some of the desires you've been rejecting aren't as bad, dangerous, or unhealthy as you've come to believe? Are your desires in control of you? Are you overindulging in what feels good without taking responsibility for the consequences? Think of someone who for you embodies true lightness of being. And the last one. Have you ever experienced true rapture? Was it wonderful, scary, enlightening? That's it. Much love and happy contemplating.